Hello everyone. Sa mga nasa online at nandito po sa loob ng aming simbahan, allow me to warmly welcome you all. We are in the Diocesan Shrine of Jesus, the Divine Word. According to Jesus, blessed are the poor, blessed are those who are hungry, blessed are those who are weeping, those who are rejected, and those who feeling down and alone. Kailan po ba ang inyong huling maalala na natagpuan niyo inyong sarili na umiiyak o naghahapis? That's what we call weeping. When was the last time? Also, you feel so rejected by life, or baka you just felt that the world is just so unfair to you, or did you also experience being hungry but no food to eat? Naalala ko tuloy yung nang bata ako, may nakita akong pamplet, yung isang congressman running for congressman, nakita ko yung kanyang pamplet, yung story ng kanyang buhay. Ang narrative niya, may point sa buhay niya na gutom siya, but wala siyang makain. Kaya naging ang motivation niya to study hard, kahit once a day lang siya kumakain. Naalala ko din yung nag-inaaway ng asawa, yung asawa niya lalaki sa tulfo. Kasi galit sa kanya yung lalaki. Ang problema, siya may trabaho, di na siya binibigyan ng pagkain. Di siya pinapakain. Sabi naman ni Tulfo, kahit galit ka dito sa asawa mo, may obligasyon ka to give her food. That's basic. Or meron ba sa atin dito one time, yung anak mo, nagingin ng pantwisyon? Pero kahit ano gawin talaga, or you may tatay ba kayo, nanay, nagingin kayo. But they cannot just simply afford. Mga kapatid, all these things can make us cry. And not only cry, but weep. Kaya nga po, magandang ginamit ni Jesus yung salitang weeping. Bakit pala? Kasi yung crying, you can cry for many different reasons. Baka siguro, yung nanood ka ng basketball, you're so engaged, tapos naka last minute, nanalo yung team mo, out of joy, napaiyak ka. Or you were waiting for a child for so long years, then it was found out you are pregnant, it can bring you joy. Pero yung salitang weeping, ginagamit lang ito sa pag-iiyak with a exact reason. Umiiyak ka because may masakit. Tagos sa kaibuturan ng ating pagkatao at puso yung sakit na ramdaman, kaya tayo ay nagtatangis. Kasi alam nyo po, karaniwan, ang tao napapayak sa sakit dahil the tears is an alternative for the words. Kasi minsan kasi, dahil sa sobrang sakit ating naramdaman, our heart is looking for available words to describe what do we feel. Pero some suffering are just too much na kahit anong hugot ng puso natin sa ilalim, no available words to describe the pain. Naalala ko tuloy yung sa maalala mo kaya. Tinanong ni Vilma Santos yung kanyang kaibigan kasi yung kanyang anak namatay lang. Bakit yung may mga balo? Pag namatay ng asawa, may tawag sa kanila, balo. Bakit yung mga anak, pag namatay ng magulang, may tawag sa kanila, ulila. Pero bakit kami mga nanay na namatay ng anak, bakit walang tawag sa amin? Hindi yun nasagot ng kaibigan niya. Pero pinag-isipan ko po yun. Walang matawag na sagot kasi the feeling was just so deep and so sacred na no words can really bring it out, can put into words. That's why you call it weeping. Did you also experience one time weeping? Kasi ako, marami akong pinagdaanan sa buhay. Nang one time, 8 years ago, yung may sakit pala ako that would need a malaking expenses and something fatal. The moment I read the diagnosis, alam nyo, yung mundo ko immediately parang crumble. Kaya minsan, naalala ko, kahit natutulog ako, nagigising na lang ako because I notice tears are falling into my face. And I believe that's why I can really relate to those people who are suffering a lot. You may also be experiencing crying while sleeping. Kaya I can also relate to many mothers, sa mga nanay na kinukwento sa akin, di daw sila minsan nakakatulog kaagad sa gabi. Or kung nakatulog man sila, maaga sila nagigising. Because thinking of many things, budget, sickness, husband, children. Alam niyo po how I manage myself through it all, how to get myself back to sleep. Well, I pray in silence. I entrust everything to the Lord. Nasabi ko, Lord, though I do not understand for now, I know you are here with me. And I keep trusting you that better future is ahead. Whether here or the next. That's the point of Jesus. Some will say, Naku, Father, that's foolish. But I call it faith. And it helped me manage myself, get to my journey this far until today, and made it alive to tell you this story. Na para sa akin, the presence of God is really true. And His promises to you and me, He will keep. Ito ang sabi ni St. Paul, kung kayo mo po pinagdaanan ngayon at lumalaban pa kayo ngayon until today, yung paglalaban nyo ngayon is not in vain, is not empty. Because kung si Jesus namatay, muling nabuhay, tayo din kanyang sasama sa kanyang muling pagkabuhay. Ibabangon niya tayo, both inside and out. That's why faith is very important. Let Jesus live in you. Let Jesus live in your mind, in your heart, in your soul, in your family. Tell yourself makakabangon. Sabi sa first part ng gospel, blessed are those who are suffering. Naalala ko yung kwento na napanood kong movie back in 2006. Sana'y napanood niyo to. Yung The Pursuit of Happiness by Will Smith. Ito pala'y true story ng isang tatay. Ang pangalan ng true story, si Chris Gardner. Ngayon, ang kwento doon, siya ay isang tatay struggling para buhay ng kanyang pamilya to keep his wife and child. And since salesman siya, alam nyo naman, hindi naman stable ang sales that time. So yung asawa niya, impatient na sa kanya. He is not earning a lot. Tapos anong nangyari, to cut the story short, iniwanan siya ng kanyang asawa. Na pinapanood ko yun, until today, I don't want to judge the wife. She must have her own reason. We can be bitter for people who left us during our downtime, but they must have their own reason, line of world, na baka they need more time to think about their actions. So for me, no judgment. Sabi ni doon sa kwento, dahil nga wala siya nabibenta, natutulog na lang siya ng kanyang anak doon sa silob ng CR kasi wala na sila matirahan. Lumingi na lang sila doon sa food, sa free food area. Tapos, ba't di nawawala yung kanyang perseverance? One day, napadaan siya sa isang may magandang sasakyan. Tinanong niya, how did you get that car? Sabi niya, because I am working as a stockbroker. How did you get there? I educate myself and I applied. So nag-apply siya, paging stockbroker. Kahit 6 months walang bayad, he really pushed. In short, nakapagtrabaho siya. He was admitted. And everything turned out fine in his life. Mga kapatid, your hunger, your weeping, your poverty, your being rejected, whatever bad situation you are now right now, tell yourself it's not final. Your situation right now is not your final destination, but the plan for God for you. That's the plan. So when you believe in God, the more you will believe in yourself, and His strength will get you through to your future goals. And sooner your goals will become your present reality. So thank God you are here to receive God's presence in your life. Kasi He will always remain faithful. He knows what we are undergoing. Naalala ko po pala, yung kwento ni Moses, why Moses was called to lead the Israelite. Kasi sabi doon sa, you have to go back to Exodus story. Tinawag ni ng Diyos si Moses para maging leader ng mga Israelite. Kasi sabi ni Lord, itong sabi niya, I heard the weeping of my own people. Narinig ko yung tangis na aking sariling mga anak. At nasaksihan ko sa aking mga mata ang kanilang paghihirap. That's why I will get out of my way and do something. I will intervene. Sabi naman ni Moses, why me? Di ko kakayanin ito. Sabi naman ni Lord, I will be with you. So friends, God knows and He will be with you. He will be faithful to His promises. Kaya nga po, during this Holy Mass, sana mamaya pagtaas ng body and blood of Jesus, kindly tell in silence, my Lord and my God. Huwag anong lakasan. Naalala ko doon sa nang bata ako, my Lord, my God. Yung matanda, my Lord, my God. Ako, nakikig ako and na-surprise tuloy ako. Kindly do it in silence, my Lord and my God. And when you feel so desperate and confused, you say, come Holy Spirit, come with your strength and your power. Come with your most special way. Give me peace. Rule me. Work in me. Lead me. Let me see what you see in me. Let me feel what you want me to feel. Widen my understanding. Deepen my sight. Heal me. Help me accept your divine will for me. To close this homily, I would like you to join me in praying the prayer which I composed for today. Lalabas po dyan sa screen and in the online. But if you have difficulty reading it, just listen to the text and script I am reading for you. I am posting this every day sa Words to Light Arpat Facebook. You can follow and like if you want daily updates. Together, Almighty God, thank you for your love and faithfulness in my life. You are the reason for my being and the purpose to keep me going in my life through it all. Father, I am confident and not afraid to face life's pain and uncertainties because I know that you are always at my side. You are my light in moments of darkness and my hope in times of distress and sorrow. Father, look after me the whole day. Help me to remain faithful, accepting, and calm, even when the situations around me do not turn out the way I expected them to happen. Strengthen my heart so that I will have enough determination to give a good fight and not to allow problems to take down my commitment in living a full life in spite of it all. In Jesus' name, amen. We continue glorifying the name of God as we continue this Holy Mass.